This is Damn 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 Show. Damn 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 Show. Oh yeah.
Your mate PG here. Given these benighted times we're living in, I thought this would be an ideal time to show you how to grow your own veg and herbs. So I'm going to call it Punk Rock Planting with PG, because I'm going to strip it all down to the basics and show that anyone can really do it, no matter whether you live in a mansion or a flat or whatever. Don't need a lot of space, don't need a garden, don't even need a cat-like badger. You can grow stuff in pots, in tubs, in dustbins, on a balcony in the backyard, pretty much anywhere. What you do need, preferably some little flower pots. I use 2-inch flower pots and I use 3.5-inch flower pots. You need something to dig a hole with. Trowel, spade is useful. Use a knife, use your fingers, or just use a spoon. Something to pour water on. And the one thing you most definitely do need is compost to grow the stuff in. And a propagator is actually pretty useful. You can buy a heated propagator online or in a shop if the shops are open for about 20 quid. Plug them in and they give a nice little bit of bottom heat to the seeds to give them a really good head start. You can use a cold propagator, which is just a tray with a plastic lid on, or you can just put the pots on a windowsill and put an old bit of a bottle top over to keep the heat in a plastic bag. At the end of this, if everybody who watches these videos just has a go at growing one thing, then my work will have been done. Have fun, enjoy, get them fingers dirty, and let's crack on. Couldn't be easier. Beans, runner, climbing, French beans, whatever you like. I've got 6 pots here, about 3.5 inches wide each. Got some multi-purpose compost. Gonna put some of that in each of these pots here and one seed in each pot. Give it a good old wash down like that to get it nice and settled. So you get your bean, I tend to plant them crossways like that rather than long ways. Get some water. I've got a posh water can here, but you can just use a cup or a bowl, whatever, kitchen sieve, just to kind of make sure it goes in a little bit lighter than straight out of a tap or something. So I'm going to remember what they are, and I'm going to put them inside the house in a propagator, but you don't need a propagator. You can just kind of put a bit of a plastic bottle top over them, something like that. That will do. Or you can get a plastic bag, tie it round with a rubber band, just to kind of keep the heat in until you see the seed start to sprout, which should probably be about 3 or 4 days. Here's one I made earlier. That was planted 6 days ago in a slightly smaller pot. Once the roots start coming out the bottom, I'm going to tap it out and put it in a bigger pot. Stay in there for another couple of weeks and then it's ready for planting out. That's the kind of Jack and the Beanstalk I just showed you. This, pretty coolly, is the top of the bean seed. It's still on there and that's how much the beans grow in there in 6 days. And these are courgettes. Okay, look at that. I mean, that's 6 days growth. Multi-purpose compost, little pot, a propagate with a bit of heat underneath it. Roots not coming through quite yet. As soon as they do, I'll be putting that on. And each one of these will probably produce, with a bit of luck, if the snails and slugs don't go in, about maybe 6 or 8 courgettes each, and you can eat the flowers. Who doesn't love a nice tassie? I don't know why I do. And they're dead easy to grow. You can grow them in the soil. You can grow them in a bucket. A dustbin is ideal. In an old sack in a potato bag. They love to grow. And from each one of these tubers, if you're lucky, you might get 10, 12, 15 potatoes. This packet cost me about, I don't know, £1.50, £2. That's pretty good going. And this particular variety is Shire. It's a sour potato, and it's blight resistant, which means it shouldn't get too much scabby stuff on the skin. First thing you always have to do with a potato is to chip them. And that simply means getting them to sprout, so they don't sit in the ground and do nothing. An egg carton is ideal for putting them in. And once these have been there about 2 weeks, and you can probably see they're just starting to get these little kind of growths on the top there. Leave them for another maybe 2 or 3 weeks, and once they've grown to about half an inch, these little sprouty bits, you need to rub them all off apart from one. You then simply dig a hole, maybe with a little bit of fertiliser at the bottom of it, plonk them in, water them, and then leave them. The one thing you need to remember about potatoes is they do like a little bit of regular watering. Between 1 and 2 inches a week is ideal. There you go, here ended today's lesson. What could be easier? See you later.